My name is Queen Mother Imamah. It sounds like some showbiz name I gave myself, which wouldn't be surprising since I've been a professional artist since age 15. Actually, it's a title conferred upon me through my African religion. I earned it. It's also the reason I wear white all the time. As a Kemetic elder high priestess, an ordained minister and scholar, wearing white becomes a rite of passage. When I announced on my global following on Facebook that I was giving my fly colorful wardrobe, it created a stir. Many wanted my old wardrobe. Wearing white has actually had little to no impact on my career as a professional working and teaching artist and producer. I designed many of my own African-centered clothes, often accented with two different earrings. I express myself through clothes. Being self-expressive is vital in life. I was born in Elizabeth, New Jersey, and raised in Kenilworth, New Jersey. I have a sister who's 2 years older than me. My grandparents chose suburban Kenilworth to build their bar, restaurant, and banquet hall in. The Ku Klux Klan burned crosses in Kenilworth, our black neighborhood. I grew up in the apartment above the family business, so I learned a lot about life, business, and family. My grandmother was the backbone of the business, even though she couldn't stand the smell or taste of alcohol and didn't drink, but it was the family business. She was in charge of the structure and the finances. Grandpa made things happen. They were a team. My grandparents were self-made farmers and sharecroppers from the Carolinas who came up north and became successful business people. Our family language is money, achievement, respect. My grandparents built their beautiful home in the black neighborhood of Rosedale, New Jersey. It's quiet and peaceful. A beautiful brick ranch that Grandpa designed and built himself on a corner lot with a fireplace for Grandma. It was a place for respite and joy to many of us over the years, including myself, after divorces. My grandparents passed away in the 80s with no debt. All of their businesses were sold off, and their properties were sold off, and all of their estates were rolled up to their children. It was expected to stay in the family. 3 decades later, the businesses were sold, and the home was lost due to high property taxes. A common story for many families today, but not ours. I come from a family of high achievers on both sides. My dad was the first African-American accepted to the NJ Tool and Die Association. My mother was the first black Girl Scout leader in Kenilworth. My maternal ancestor, Billy Artist, fought in the Nat Turner Uprising. South Carolina Congressman Jim Clyburn is my cousin. So is John Legend. Him I've never met. As an artist, it can be difficult to find organizations that value you and your work. The community should support one another, especially among artists and those who employ artists. Many artists today experience hunger, illness, isolation from family members who don't understand the art profession, money issues. There are so many of us many artists are left waiting unjustifiably for paychecks from organizations that are careless about getting our money to us in a reasonable time frame. In the meantime, the administrators are living comfortably, flaunting vacations and cushier lifestyles. Understand, I'm an administrator and producer too, but I know the world from both sides. I'm determined to be a bridge. The ignorance of art administrators is no different than society at large, but we must help one another get through. If artists band together to help, support, and stand up against this kind of injustice, we can truly be an artist community. Struggling in isolation creates new levels of desperation, bitterness, and cutthroat opportunism. Like Scarlett O'Hara in Gone with the Wind, God as my witness, I'll never be hungry again. That's the deeper reason why we have so much disunion. I've coached many artists over the years, spiritually and in business. My passions are spirituality, art, and business. To this day, I try my best to share them all to empower my community. I currently live in Newark, New Jersey with my husband. We appreciate the lovely home and neighborhood we live in. My place reminds me of my grandparents' place and my grandparents' house in Roselle, New Jersey, in so many ways. I want to inspire other artists. My advice to everyone is to value themselves and each other, share resources, build community, and learn the business of art.